And so when we are reaching out to our local representatives in the form of going to a town hall, or even when we're reaching out to our federal representatives, we can ask. I believe it's all about asking quick questions and having awareness, asking the right questions to the right people, right? And so I think some of the fundamental questions we should be asking is, how much does this, will this cost us as taxpayers? Anything that relates to immigration, waters, detention, you know, whatever it is, courts, as we hear changes, we ask that question. How much is it costing us as taxpayers? Second question, who's profiting? Because I think that's a critical question that we need to be asking more of. And third, ask your representatives to explain to you how this is impacting various categories of immigrants, right? So let's just assume that there's more than one category, right? And let's assume now that you know that DACA and Dreamers are not synonymous. All DACA recipients are Dreamers, but not all Dreamers are DACA, right? Now that you know that, ask those questions. From a corporate standpoint, or you know, business standpoint, right now, Amazon, Salesforce, tech companies are sharing their databases with the US government. This is a problem because they're actually contributing to this mass, you know, deportation. So these companies can stop doing that. I think that's one way. But then the other is they can be involved in lobbying because they ultimately benefit a lot from migration, immigration. And so they should be lobbying for things like HR 6, where they're getting a tremendous number of Dreamers or DACA recipients who are actually working for their organizations and their companies. So I think those are just some of the ways that we can, as individuals, help. Another way is get involved with local organizations that focus on immigration. ISIS, United We Dream, DocuBlack, American Immigration Council. These are all organizations where you could actually volunteer as an ally if you want to. As I mentioned, there are hundreds, actually there are over 700,000 pending immigration cases to speak of, right? And we know that the majority of people, immigrants that walk through those courtrooms, do not have legal representation. If you're an attorney, you know, I'm sure it would be helpful to volunteer if you know someone, or you could actually just be a volunteer and go to these hearings with these individuals, right? So there are various ways in which we can volunteer our time, and at the very least, just the knowledge and knowing where to get the knowledge. I think this audience, of course, we don't need to talk about where to access the knowledge, but I think for you know, the larger public, I've been asked many times, where do I get this information? There's so much out there. Where do I go? Right? So I would say start with the Brookings Institution. Go on the website. You know, like there are certain organizations and think tanks that you can refer to and know that they have credible numbers and statistics and